What is going on, everybody? It is your boy Nothing But Skills, bringing you guys another Division 2 video. Man, how good does it sound to say Division 2? I know you guys are excited. I'm excited. Division 2 is less than a year away, and we have so much to talk about. This video is really going to be focused on everything that we know from E3. So we got a lot of new information, and I know you guys are probably overwhelmed with all the information. You have so many questions. So what I figured I would do for you guys is bring you guys a video that would answer all those questions that you guys might have. We'll be talking about a lot of things that we've heard in E3, and then I'll be trying to clear up all the fake stuff, the real stuff, and hopefully give you guys a video that you guys can walk away with and have a lot less questions than you had before you watched this video. But before we get into all the details, one thing I want you guys to watch is Ubisoft did send me over this short video of my name being engraved into the Division 2 statue. I know a lot of you guys have heard about this, and a way you guys can get on the Division 2 statue is by signing up for the beta. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna watch it real quick, and then we'll get into the video. So here we go. So to me, that was an honor. I'm super excited that I was chosen by Ubisoft to head out to capture some gameplay. If you haven't watched that gameplay video, make sure you go watch my last video. None of that gameplay will be in this video. All my exclusive gameplay was in my last video. So if you guys want to take a look at that video, there'll be a link up top. Also, at the end of this video, there will be a link that takes you to that video. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is the release date. So we finally got the release date during the E3 presentation at the Xbox conference. So March 15th is the release date for Division 2. That's March 15, 2019. If you guys haven't already, you guys can sign up for the beta. I'll put a link down below in the description box, and that way you guys can sign up from that link. That is a perfect way for you guys to test out the game yourself and to decide if you guys want to pre-order it or not. So what do we know about the location for Division 2? Well, we do know that the location for Division 1 was in New York City, and for Division 2, it will now be 6 months later in the summertime, no longer the wintertime, in Washington, D.C. So what type of weather can we have, since, remember, in New York City, it was all snow, fog, cold weather. We really didn't have to deal with anything else. Well, now 6 months later, we're in Washington, D.C., and it is the summertime, so we're dealing with extreme heat instead of extreme cold. And then, of course, we most likely will have to deal with some storms. No one really knows what type of weather we will be dealing with in Division 2. The really cool thing I've talked about in my last video and I'm talking about in this video is the map size for Washington, D.C. is a 1x1 replica. So if you guys are from the D.C. area, you guys might know a lot of the monuments and you might know a lot of the buildings in the area, because this is a 1x1 real replica of Washington, D.C. And that took them a lot of time, and the amount of detail and time that they took to create that is really amazing. One thing I do want you guys to know, that being a 1x1 replica of Washington, D.C. will make the Division map be 20% larger than Division 1. So if we look at the full map of Division 1, Division 2 map is going to be 20% larger than this, and that is confirmed. So what are some big changes that we're going to see in Division 2 from Division 1? Well, the first big change that you guys probably already heard of is there will no longer be any signature skills. So your recovery link, which heals and cures the user and nearby allies, revives allies in range, and then when you're running solo, it automatically triggers when you're about to die. For tactical link, we have the weapon enhance system, which provides temporary increased damage and weapon performance to the user and all nearby allies. And then survival link is increased damage resistance and speed for the user and group members. So you get an additional 50% damage resistance, and then you get that additional 30% movement speed. So these are some big changes, because when you run in a group in Division 1, a lot of people pop survival link, tactical link, and recovery link. And with no longer having the signature skills, that's going to be a big change in itself. Now, what replaces the signature skills in Division 2? So if you haven't heard about the specializations, you might want to check out the Division website. They do have some more information on the specializations. Upon reaching level 30, Division agents will be able to activate one of several specializations. Each one unlocks a unique signature weapon and additional skills that offer new ways to play. Now, so far, they're only showing us three specializations. We have the survival Survivalist, we have the Demolitionist, and then we have the Sharpshooter. If you haven't watched my gameplay from E3, check out the video at the end of this video and you'll see me playing the Demolitionist. But let's talk about each one. So the Survivalist, if we click on learn more, Survivalists can control their surroundings using traps, status effects. They are equipped with precision crossbows as the signature weapon to take their targets down, even in the hardest of environments. A lot of you guys might wonder, well, if we select a specialization, do we lose on one of our equipped weapons? You will still have two primary, and then you do have a secondary, so it will be a pistol. And then of course, you'll have another slot for your specialization weapon, depending on which route you go. Now for the Demolitionist, instead of having a crossbow, you do have a grenade launcher. So Demolitionists are agents of chaos, focusing on disrupting enemy plans and entrenching positions using a grenade launcher as their signature weapon. So instead of a crossbow as your signature weapon, you'll have a grenade launcher. And then for sharpshooters, sharpshooters can change the tide of the battle from afar using a powerful sniper rifle as their signature weapon. And the one that I saw during a demo was a 50 cal sniper rifle. So I'm not sure if that will change depending on how you level up your sharpshooter. But yes, it was a 50 cal sniper rifle during the demo. Now, a lot of people have been asking about PvP because there has been no PvP footage at E3 in the demo. And I didn't have access to any PvP. All I had access to at E3 was the demo, which was more PvE focused. But don't worry, guys, they did confirm that there is PvP. Now, they haven't said what type of PvP will we have. Will we have the Dark Zone? Will we have Last Stand? Will we have Skirmish? Nobody really knows what type of PvP action that we're going to have in the Division 2, but just know there is PvP and they will confirm that at a later date. Now, one other cool thing with PvP that they did confirm is there will be clans. So that is something new that we didn't see in the Division. There are clans that you can set up and have with your friends, with people you meet. So not only is that going to work on the PvE side, that's going to work on the PvP side. So that's pretty cool. And then create something that people start to remember throughout the Division. So I think that's a really cool feature that a lot of people are going to like, is the whole clan system, having that clan tag above your name. And then people just getting to know those clans as the top PvP clans, the top PvE clans, or just a really good community. I think that is amazing and something that was needed in Division 1. And I'm really glad that they're bringing this to the Division 2. So let's finally get to what a lot of people have been asking about, is gears and weapons. So we know in the Division that we have everything from gold gear to classified gear. And a lot of people were wondering, are we really going to have gear sets in the Division 2? And I personally didn't want to see gear sets in the Division 2. I wanted to see more gold gear and you customizing those gear sets in the Division 2. So in the last Division 2 stream, they did give us a really good close look at gear. And one thing I did notice is they did just show us purple gear. So it seems that purple and gold gear are what you're going to be looking for in the Division 2 as you start to level up your character. Now, I'm assuming gold will be better just like it was in Division 1. One thing I did notice is they do have attributes just like we have in Division 1, but the new key thing that they do have on there is called brand sets. As you have three of those brand sets, that means that you will unlock something new on that gear. And that is really cool. So that kind of goes away from having to worry about gear sets and just the gear itself. Now, where's the brand on the gear? If you look right next to the item, so if we're looking at the backpack, there is a symbol there. So that is one brand. If you look at the gloves underneath it, that's a different brand. Depending on how many of those that you have at the same brand will unlock more stuff. But the cool feature that they did say is each brand is more specific to certain playstyles. And once we learn more about the brands and what the brands will bring to the game, then we'll know what brands we really want to spec into. But for now, all we know is there are brands. And then if you're holding three pieces of one brand, you unlock the full potential of that gear piece. Now, if you're only holding one piece, then it's only one part of that gear piece. Two pieces of that brand, then you unlock two pieces. And that is something really cool. And I feel will give a lot of customization to the Division 2 and a lot more build diversity than we've seen in Division 1 for sure. So one other thing I did want to point out is they have gone away from firearms, stamina, and electronics, but there still is a version of stamina, which is health. If you look on the left-hand side, you'll see where it says health on there. So it's pretty much stamina, right? And then we do have skill power, so it's pretty much electronics. And then they have armor on there, which they separated armor and health on here versus on the Division 1. Armor and health are together, and that's what makes your toughness. So we have armor, health, and skill power, and then your weapon will show your DPS. So let's get into the weapons, guys. At the very top, you'll see you have your specialty weapon that's really highlighted, and it's either going to be locked or unlocked. And then on the right-hand side, to show how much you have for that ammo. Underneath is where you're going to have your main weapons. You can have a lightweight M4, a shotgun, depending on how you build your character. Right next to it will have your secondary weapon, your pistol. So you have your primary, your second primary, you have your secondary, which is going to be your pistol, and then above it's going to be your specialty weapon. Another cool feature they did get to show off was the weapon attachments. So no longer do we have to grind for those weapon attachments or craft those weapon attachments or even have to hold on to them, because a lot of you guys know the stash became a horrible place near the end of Division 1. Weapon attachments are unlockable. So once you unlock, say, a 12x scope or a 3.4 scope, that attachment will be unlocked for all your weapons. So all you have to do is go to your weapon and then select the attachment. So one thing they did say with the weapon attachments, since they are unlockables, they kind of want to get away from this whole best in slot for each weapon. They want it to be where you could customize a weapon where it would help it, it would hurt it. It's just something that you build around your playstyle and you have a lot of fun with. And I'm honestly glad I don't have to carry 100 different weapon mods in my stash. Remember, the key takeaway from this is once you unlock the weapon mod, you can use that weapon mod on any weapon you have, and it will always be there. Once you click on the weapon, all you have to do is select the weapon mod you want to put on, the scope, the grip, whatever you want to put on the weapon, and it will be there. So it's no longer having going to your stash to switch it up. You can switch it up whenever you want. So that's enough about weapons and gear. Now let's get into end game content. So they have been talking about a lot of end game content and what they will be bringing. So the plan for end game content, once you complete the game, is 2 to 3 weeks after the game has been launched is when they will be bringing in those 8-man raids that everybody keep talking about. So instead of them having incursions, they will be going to those 8-man raids. So you can say goodbye to all the incursions that we have in the Division 1. You won't see those in Division 2. You will see those raids, which are going to be a lot harder and give you better rewards. So that is something that I'm really excited for. And not only raids coming after 2 weeks, they did say that we will have a free year of DLC. So what we're going to get during that full year is those free story driven missions. So it's going to supplement the story mode that we already have from the base game of Division 2. We're also going to get map expansions, so we'll be able to explore other areas, and then new game features, which I'm assuming is game mode. A lot of really good stuff coming to Division 2. If you guys aren't hyped for this game, I don't know what to say. I'm super, super hyped, and I can't wait to find out what they have in store for the Division 2. And as we find out more information about PvP and what they have planned for PvP, I will be bringing you guys that content. I hope you guys are enjoying 1.8.2. It did just drop today, so definitely check that out. I will have a video later on about the shields and try to explain them a little bit better to you. So remember guys, if you guys enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. If this is the first time you're watching one of my videos, hit that subscribe button. And if you have any questions after watching this video, use the comment section down below. Thank you guys again for all the support. And remember, if you don't see me in Last Stand, Skirmish, or the Dark Zone, it's only a matter of time. Nothing but skills is out.